how my fuel line turned out. I'm gonna make this one a little bit longer and tie it up here. Actually going downhill like that. Doesn't make any difference, I know. But, 5 pounds of fuel pressure, 4 or 5. Got it idled down real low right now. About 700 or 800 RPM. Oh, it needs a little more juice there. So easy to do. There's a little more juice. Forget about surging. No relays, no computer, no oxygen sensors, no mass air meter, no map sensor. I think that's around 4,000 RPM. Let's see what happens. Just put the fuel tank back in. The fuel pump is right there now. I cut the line too short. So anyway, I like it better than being in the engine bay. Grounded right there. I'm gonna throw some quad shocks on here soon. These might be the original. So I'm gonna pull those off and replace those. I know the shocks are been replaced a couple times maybe. Look how it's running. Of course, I'm playing around with this tack. I'm gonna mount it on the dashboard. Let me do that shift light. Let me put it on 4,000. If I can make the shift light work here, I'll turn it down to a low setting right here. See what happens here. There it is. Got it set at about 3,000 RPM. Okay. Thank you. not going to leave it out here on the cow, by the way. That's just, it's just playing around. It'll be inside when I finally get it shed and done. If I can make the shift light work here, I'll turn it down to a low setting right here. See what happens here. There it is. Got it set at about 3,000 RPM. Okay. I'm not going to leave it out here on the cow, by the way. That's just, it's just playing around. It'll be inside when I finally get it shed and done. Just one line now for the fuel line. Does not need a return line. It's just capped off. Fuel pump is in the front now instead of fuel pump originally in this type car is in here. Let's see if the tach works. I think that's around 4,000 RPM. See what happens.